Hello friends, once more welcome back to our channel Kiddo Care. I am Dr Anurag, I'm the Pediatrics. Today I am going to explain you some 5 points about dog bite. These 5 points remain confusing like anything for each and everyone. So today I am going to clear it forever and ever. So point number 1 is, what is the very first thing which you have to do after dog bite? Second thing, whether tetanus toxoid has to be given or not. Tetanus toxoid is injection TT. Third point, something about rabies vaccine and rabies immunoglobulin. Fourth point, in case of rat bite, are you supposed to get the vaccination or not? And the fifth point and the most important point, if your dog is well vaccinated, fully vaccinated, in that case, whether you are supposed to take rabies vaccines or not. So, without wasting your time, let's start our session. Point number 1. The very first thing that you have to do is soap and water wash. Whether it's a simple scratch or an abrasion or laceration or transdermal wound, the very first thing is to wash it with water and soap. Yes, I'm again pressurizing, saying water. People are afraid of putting water on the wounds, especially over dog bite wound. But you have to put water along with soap and you have to clean it gently and properly. This was our first. Second point, injection TT. See, the thing is, if you have taken injection tetanus toxoid in previous 5 years, within 5 years, then you are not supposed to take TT again. But your previous injection was before 5 years, then you are supposed to take one additional dose of TT injection tetanus toxoid. Third point is regarding rabies vaccine and RIG. So regarding rabies vaccine, there are two schedules which are followed in India. The first one is intramuscular and the second one is intradermal. Intramuscular means you have to inject the drug into your muscles, and intradermal means in the layers of the skin. So here the doses vary. Intramuscular, you have to give either 1 ml and 0.5 ml depending on the brand, depending on the type. Whereas in intradermal, only you have to give inject 0.1 ml in both the shoulders. So effectively it comes out to be 0.2 ml per dose. So you have to go for 5 doses schedule in intramuscular case, and this is again mandatory. Don't go for 3 dose schedule, that is 0-3-7, and watching your dog whether he remains alive or not. If the dog is alive, then you just leave in between, and if the dog dies, then you go for all the 5 doses. But here one thing I should mention before you, that you have to take all the 5 doses whether the dog dies or the dog remains alive. Second part, that is RIG. So rabies immunoglobulin is required only in cases of category 3. If there is transdermal wound, then only you are supposed to take RIG locally at the point of the bite and the remaining amount at shoulder intramuscularly. So this completes our point number 3. Coming to point number 4, that is rat bite. There is no need of rabies vaccine in case of rats. Lots of cases come and they say that my child has been bitten by a rat. So whether should I go for rabies vaccination or not? The answer is very clear, that you are not supposed to take vaccine in case of rat bite. Yeah, if it's cat bite, if it's monkey bite, if it's dog bite, it's wolf, jackals, bats, in that cases, you are supposed to take rabies vaccine. And the fifth and the most important point, that is, in case of well vaccinated dog, will you go for vaccination or not? The answer is very simple. Not all the vaccines are 100% effective. Not all the vaccines are 100% safe. So in case of benefit of doubt, you should go for proper vaccination even after the dog has been immunized previously. The second point, the second school of thought, what they say that in those cases you can prevent, you can avoid vaccination, but there you have to go for serological test for the dog antibodies. If rabies antibodies are properly formed in the dog, in that case only you can just avoid rabies immunization. Otherwise, you have to go for PEP, that is post-exposure prophylaxis, even in cases of well-immunized dogs. These 5 points are clear to you. And in case of any problem, any confusion, you can just put comment in our comment box and surely I'll give you answer. Thank you.